streams in the desert as the sun begins to inch its way over the horizon. Looking forward to 101 or more. For the vision is yet for an appointed time. Though it tarry, wait for it, because it will surely come. It will not tarry. Habakkuk 2:3. In the charming little booklet, Expectation Corner, Adam Sloman was led to the Lord's treasure house. And among many other wonders there revealed to him was the delayed blessing office, where God kept certain things prayed for until the wise time came to send them. It takes a long time for some pensioners to learn that the delays are not denials. Ah, there is the secrets of love and wisdom in the delayed blessings department, which are a little dreamt of. Men would pluck their mercies green when the Lord would have them wait until they are ripe. Therefore will the Lord wait, that he may be gracious unto you. Isaiah 30:18. He is watching in the hard places, and he will not allow one trial too many. He will let the cross be dross be consumed, and then he will come gloriously to be your help. Do not grieve him by doubting his love. Nay, lift up your head and begin to praise him even now for the deliverance which is on the way to you. You will be abundantly rewarded for the delay. Just try your faith. You know, when we do recognize that there is timing to what God does, as well as to purpose, when we know that there is a plan that operates according to a schedule, when we arrange our lives in a certain pattern to follow that timing and the schedule and the process that takes us from sinner to salvation, from imperfect to perfect, then it makes it so much easier to know that God is with us and to let God be the one in control of all of our finances, all of our emotions, all of our faith, all of our decisions, and really become the man, the woman, the young adult, the child, the person that God wants to use for his glory. Because you see, it's all a matter of making it easier on yourself or harder, because whether you know it or not, God will still honor his promises, bless you when he chooses to, instruct you in his righteousness, teach you the way you should go, will accomplish his purposes with or without you, will still do with or without you participating with him in his will. The benefit of trusting him in faith is that you get a blessing from it, is that there's something that's wonderfully done when a Christian knows that God will come through. And it's like a coming up to the edge of the cliff and stepping on solid ground when there appears to be nothing beneath the feet. It's such a rush. It's such a joy. You know, and people around want to see what a Christian will do when the hard times hit. They already know what the world will do. They already know what everyone else should do. But what makes you unique and different is that God already told you ahead of time what to do, how to do, and what you should be when the trials come. So don't be surprised if when you pray you don't have an immediate answer sometimes. It's because the Lord is just preparing you for the times when you know that whatever you prayed, God came through, just not in the way or the timing that you expected. I like to say, all my prayers are answered. And to this day, I still think that there isn't one prayer that I've prayed that I haven't seen the Lord move in his way and accomplish his purpose. And I don't mean by compromising what I've asked for. I mean by just waiting his timing. So if the timing is off for you right now, if it's too early, or if it's seemingly too late, ask him. I did. Seek the Lord to find out why. Listen when he shared with you his timing and what he wills for you. You may be surprised. You might be challenged, but you may be surprised that his timing is perfect. You just have to get past it sometimes to look back on it to know that it was perfect.
But you'll see.